In this video, we're going to study the subspace topology and the order topology together. We saw that both subspace and order topologies could be very complicated depending on the set we were working with. But now let's see how things can get extremely complicated when joining them. We know that in the real numbers in the plane, we can define the order dictionary, and this gives us a topology. Let's call it tau dic. If you don't remember about this topology, I recommend you check out the video on the order topology first. Now let's consider the set I to be the interval 0, 1. And let's think about possible topologies that we can define on I squared. Well, I can think of two topologies. The first one will be the inherited topology as a subspace of R2 with the dictionary topology. That is, we can take any open interval in the dictionary order and intersect it with I times I. And the other topology that we can think of is the topology of the dictionary order restricted to the unit square. So are these two topologies the same? Let's make a drawing to see that they are not. So let's consider the set 1/2 times the interval 1/2, 1, closed in 1. The idea will be to determine if this set is open or not in each of these topologies. Here we have 1/2, and so the interval will be open in here and closed here. But is this set open in the inherited topology? Whenever we work with the inherited topology, we have to remember that we are a subspace, meaning that there are other sets in addition to the ones we have inside our set. And for example, this set can be written as this open interval intersection our unit square. So in the inherited topology, this set, the 1/2 times 1/2, 1, is I times I intersection the 1/2 times, for example, 1/2, 2. And because the 1/2, 2 is open in the plane with a dictionary order topology, then the intersection with the unit square will be open in the unit square with the subspace topology. But what happens when we consider the topology of the dictionary order restricted to the unit square? In this case, if I want to grab an open set, then the intervals will immediately jump to the other side. So if this is 1/2, the 1/2, 1 is not open, because given that the dictionary order is restricted to the unit square, the 1/2, 1 is a half open interval, and half open intervals are not in our set. So there is a big difference between the two topologies. And now we can ask ourselves, okay, under what circumstances are these two topologies the same? Because what's happening here is that this limit, this border we have here at 1, is giving us problems. So what if we didn't have it? Well, then we would have maybe a problem here when we work with a set like this. So we also would have to remove this other set. So if we really want to understand what's going on, we have to draw the whole plane. Now the unit square would be something like this. But now don't think about the unit square as a subspace of anything. Just imagine it's a square in there and grab two points inside of it. In the plane, with a dictionary topology, if we want to draw the interval that these two points form, then we get something like this. We come from the beginning, as, let's say it's an open interval, we go the ray up to plus infinity, and then we would have all the intermediate rays up to this one, where we get, again, the open interval at the point, and the ray up to minus infinity. Obviously, these lines are just an illustration, but it will be one vertical line for each real number. And so what happens is, if you now look at your unit square, you see that it's getting cut off. If we had another set, let's say that our interval, instead of being the unit square, it was something like this. A ray and another ray delimiting our whole set. Now, if we take two points here and we draw the intervals, we would get something like this. So, in this case, our set is not being cut off by anything. Well, this is the definition of convex, because essentially here, in the first case, we can write our unit square as a union of many open rays. And all these rays, they are all disjoint. Remember, again, there is one ray per each real number, so this is dense. It's not as discrete as I'm drawing it. But then I can write my set as a union of disjoint sets. Here, I cannot, because these sets go to infinity and then they come back here. So I cannot divide it into sections. Well, that is the definition of a set being convex. That definition is usually illustrated as, well, a set that has many parts like this is not convex, whereas if a set has only one part, it is. And the unit square, it seems like it only has one part, but when you draw the intervals, you realize it doesn't. So maybe the reason why these two topologies are different is because we're working with the unit square, and the unit square is not convex. Well, let's see this with a theorem. The theorem says that we have x, another set, in the other topology. So again, we have x and the topology given by some simple order. We have a subspace of x that's convex, then the other topology on y is the same as the topology y inherits as a subspace of x. So essentially here the plane would be x, the unit square would be y, and so it says that, well, if it was convex, which is not, then these two topologies would be the same. So let's give everything a few names. The other topology on y, I'm going to denote it as tau restricted to y, the order restricted to y, and the topology y inherits as a subspace, I will denote it as tau y, and to not forget that it's from the subspace, super s. So let's start with the proof. What we want to prove is that tau y s is equal to tau order restricted to y. Let's start proving this inclusion. The subspace topology is equal to the order topology of y. For this, we will just use the definition of inclusion. We will take one element here and prove that it's here. Now, without loss of generalization, I can suppose that my element here is going to be, because it's a subset, it will be y intersection some open set in the x topology. X has the order topology, so the set I will have to intersect will be an interval. And without loss of generality, I can suppose that that interval is going to be a ray. It would be the same for orders. This is just to make things a bit faster. So let's see if this element is in the order topology of y. For this, let's make a small drawing. I know we are in an abstract space, but let's suppose that this is our set x, and this set here is y. Now remember, y is convex, so y cannot be some piece here and another piece here, because this set is not convex. And I'm just assuming that the order in x will be like this. So an element here is smaller than an element here. So let's delete all this. And now the ray is going to be, I have three options for the position of A. A could be here, it could be here, or it could be here. In these three cases, we would have the open ray in that direction. So what is y intersection A infinity? Well, if we were in the purple situation, we would have that the intersection of all this with y is going to be our set Y. And let me say if A is a lower bound of Y. If we were on this other situation, then the intersection would be the empty set. And in this case, A is an upper bound. And finally, in this other situation, the intersection would be A and the end of Y, if Y is a bounded set. So this is a ray in Y. But now all of these elements, the set itself, the empty set, and the rays, these are all elements in the order topology of Y. And so Y intersection array is an element in the order topology of Y. And with this, we have this first inclusion. But now the other inclusion is trivial, because obviously any ray in Y has to be of the form A infinity intersection Y or minus infinity A intersection Y. And given that this ray or this other, these are two elements in the X topology given by the order in X, then we were able to write some ray in Y as an intersection of an open set in X intersection Y. So we have the double inclusion, and this proves the theorem. If you like these types of videos and you want to support the channel, we take very small donations on Ko-fi. Also, if you want to further support the channel, we have Patreon available with amazing merchandise. We also have a store for you to buy mathematics t-shirts.